the other side of boulevards and broken dreams. I covered up the pride, but deep inside it's hide and seek. Deep down I'm trying to find that peace of mind, some certainty. I saw the reasons why up on a sign that's passing me. I lost the best of myself. I lost the best of myself. My skin was porcelain, I'm crumbling down.
It's not that I'm sad, it's not that I'm weak.
If I'm not a Swiftie by now, then I'm doing something wrong with my life. What's going on, YouTube? Yes, I am well aware. We have a brand new surprise Taylor Swift album. I mean, this thing looks crazy. 30 tracks on it. We're going to start diving into some of this. I'm not sure how I'm going to approach it and attack it. But anyways, first on deck, we got the song with her and Post Malone. So this right here right now is none other than Fortnite. But before getting further, listen, if you like that quick intro track, I have a brand new music video dropping this Tuesday, a song that means a lot to me. That's a little bit of a snippet from it. If you guys want to check it out, support the channel directly. I'll put all links to that below. Also, shout out to the hat that I'm wearing. If you guys like it, you want to support the channel, noxillmusic.com, limited edition, while supplies last. We sold out of the white ones like crazy last time. So if you want to get your black one while it's in store, again, I'll put all links down there.
Was supposed to be sent away, but they forgot to come and get me. I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic. All of this to say, I hope you're okay, but you're the reason.
What about your quiet treason? Cheating. Treason. The way she sets that up. But listen, what in the Stranger Things is going on here, right? I feel like Stranger Things really brought back the appreciation for like the 80s and like the retro synths. And this has sort of that nostalgic sound with the synths and the way that this balances and just hits. And even her voice is just like super reverbed, almost kind of haunting in the mix, especially her method of delivery with this one. It's like a ghost of the past, I feel like, listening to this. But I just want to bring it back and appreciate some of the lyrics that she's saying here, because there's some thought behind this. And I mean, some huge lines too, like being a functioning alcoholic, but nobody noticed her aesthetic. Nobody really took note of what she was doing. But why is she an alcoholic? Because of your treason, because of what she went through. Interesting. And then the sent away lines to like a mental ward or recovering, like a recovering addict too.
Yeah.
Because she does like to talk about love being a drug a lot, right? And she has a lot of lyrics that dive into that world and metaphors that she uses for that. So I could see those connections throughout this too.
I was a functioning alcoholic till nobody noticed my new aesthetic.
Aesthetic. I feel like that's Post off to the side right there. Just again, and it's just almost like ghost filling the space, the mix, just different like harmonies and hummings just happening layered, like way down in the vocal space.
All of this to say, I hope you're okay, but you're
and two different drum lines, one running on this side and one just way off to the sides as well. I love the way she says that. No one hears the blame, right? But what's really interesting is that, you know, she's doing self-harmful behavior, right? So she could be to blame in a sense, but she's not taking responsibility for it. Also, she could easily point the finger at why she went down this rabbit hole with the quiet treason and all that, but no one's to blame in that sense too. It's almost like a devil may care type of attitude, but I can't help but think that there's just irony underneath that lyricism there. Even, and you hear there, just the little hums that are just, yeah, filling the space in different places, man. A lot's happening in the mix. So,
and no one here's to blame, but what about your quiet treason? And for a fart,
was that church bells underneath there? Might have been.
Neighbors, your wife waters flowers.
What? All my mornings are my- Your wife waters flowers, I want to kill her. Oh, the treason now takes a new turn. I mean, that's a great line. Like, you just see Taylor just waving out the window to the neighbors and to the wife watering the roses when really she's got that kitchen knife on deck. All my mornings are Mondays, because who loves Mondays, honestly? If you love Mondays, there's something wrong with you in your life. And then in endless February, endlessly cold. Nobody really likes February either, unless it's Valentine's, I guess. What a great line. I took the miracle move on drug, but the effects were temporary. And see, I take that as miracle move on drug that could tie in with the functioning alcoholic. Like, she turned to alcohol to help her move on, but the effects were temporary because long term, she's still not truly over it or dealing with it, right? She's kind of running away from the situation and fully addressing it. That's why nobody's to blame at the beginning. There's no taking accountability, no taking responsibility for it and really trying to address the elephant in the room and move forward. Do, do, da, 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 da. Just that little, again, very spaced out, slow delivery. Like, I feel like it's perfect for this beat. It's almost like lulling you, like, laid back into this false sense of security with it all. Oh, well, now a new player has entered the arena. She's got a husband in this case, and now he's cheating. Isn't that ironic when obviously she was having an affair and they're pretending to be good neighbors when she's having an affair with one of the neighbors and that ties in, but it only lasted a fortnight. It was a fling. But I feel like this is all metaphorical for one of her relationships, right? She dated anyone British because a fortnight, very British term. I've got a British wife. That's 2 weeks, right? Sounds very, very specific. And no, it's not Travis Kelce because that relationship is still going down. I mean, what a great line. Put that on a Valentine's Day card. I love you. It's ruining my life. I mean, that's everything. It's ruining my life. It's ruining my life. Is this Post Malone's feature? Is he just a backing singer the whole time? Oh, builds. Buy the car you want. Move to Florida. That's how you get over your problems. Florida is the Wild West, boys and girls. But touch me. It won't start till you touch me, right? Like push to start on the car versus flipping that into a metaphor. Touch me. And Post Malone is finally getting his time to shine on this track. It's dope, though. I love the layering to this. There's a lot happening vocally in the mix. Like, I hear Taylor Swift, like, doing harmonies off to the side, way back in the space, and then her stacked underneath the Post. And then there are other moments when he was stacked underneath of her. So, yeah, I always love when you take a female and a male voice and you juxtaposition those two because they have different ranges, right? And the stacking of that just always sounds so great to the eardrums. And notice how that just kind of reverbs and echoes around the space as we end. Really interesting choice for, like, this being the premier track from it all, right? This doesn't sound like that sort of typical hit number one single that everybody's going to sing along to. This feels like one of those, like, the more you listen to it, the more it catches on, really. The more you'll appreciate it, right? Totally different vibe. And again, like, yeah, very da, 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 da. Like, just kind of space out. And think about this and really, like, feel your way through this one. Yeah, I enjoyed that track. Taylor Swift, Post Malone, you were Noxo certified. Hope you guys like today's video. Listen, for some reason you're here at the end. Obviously, enjoying the content. Do me a huge favor. Support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. Really, really does go a long way. I love you guys. Stay safe, stay positive. It's Wally Noxo. You know, I'll catch you again.